Boy, it is a gorgeous day here in Southeast Pennsylvania. It's hard to believe that the world is facing a crisis like we've never faced before. But you know what? There's hope because the Bible tells us we are more than conquerors. I'm going to talk to you about it in your morning cup of inspiration. Some of my favorite verses in the Bible are found in Romans 8. And I'm going to read from Romans 8, starting with verse 37. And I'll go through verse 39. It says, "Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us." Right there, all these things. That includes the coronavirus. Verse 38, "For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." When you take a close look at those verses, you realize that Paul has written almost any circumstance, any outside force, and none of it can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And that's what he starts with in verse 37. "We are more than conquerors through him that loved us." Verse 38 says, "For I am persuaded." That means Paul's saying, I have the great hope that these things are true. That neither death nor life. Why would he start with death and life? Well, those are the greatest extremes we can experience on earth. God breathes life into us at our birth, and death is the great separator. It separates us from our loved ones, but that can't separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Nor principalities, nor powers, nor angels. He actually starts, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers. Now, angels obviously are God's servants. They work for God and they bring messages to the earth. They protect us, they guide us, so they would never try to separate us. But principalities and powers, those two words are used 6 times throughout the Bible in that same fashion, principalities and powers. Principalities often refers to Satan and his rule and his dominion and his demons, whereas powers refer to earthly authorities. So you've got the spiritual forces that come against us, earthly authorities that are over us. They can't separate us from the love of God. And then he says, nor things present, nor things to come. That is all of time. Nothing can separate us. Nor height, nor depth. That's space. You can go anywhere on the earth. You can't be separated from God, from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. So nothing. The coronavirus is nothing in God's eyes. He knows about it. He is getting our attention. He wants us to turn to his son, Jesus Christ. Let me pray for you. If you don't know Jesus as your Savior, pray this simple prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I ask you to send your son, Jesus Christ, into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. I want to live my life for you. Cleanse me. Make me a new creature in thy name. Amen. We'd love to hear from you if you prayed that prayer. We are praying for you here at Fearless Faith. God bless you, and I'll see you soon for another morning cup of inspiration.